So we're going south with Fabio.
Yeah. What are we making?
Or things are going south. Yeah. I don't know. One of them.
Either way, it's a correct statement.
Yeah. Okay. Okay.
We are doing a little spin on shrimp and grits.
Okay, so it's a southern dish.
It's a southern dish from South Carolina.
Y'all.
South Carolina.
That was your accent with the end of y'all. And I got scolded once because I used to make grits and shrimp, but my shrimp were very brothy. A lot of tomato sauce, and this friend I have from this down south said, nope, the grits has to be creamy, but yeah. The shrimp with the mushroom and any other ingredient make it thick. Otherwise, you're gonna have soup, not grits. And I said, ha-ha.
Is that what you said?
Wait. I said, ha-ha. And now I nailed...
You dressed in a pirate costume when you said that.
Yeah. It was my accent with a pirate expression.
Yes, it was.
Yes.
Say, I will get you, Pan.
Yes. Too many accents. All right. Moving on.
Here it comes. You're going to see it now, then.
Here it comes.
And Dr. There. Paul, you're going
please,
to get
please.
Some,
too. Okay. Oh, yes.
Look at that. Looks delicious. Sorry, guys. You don't get any.
No, absolutely.
Just pass it on.
So what do we start with?
So we have... We got shrimp.
Two is all we need. Thank you so much.
Salt, pepper. And here's what we do. We're going to mix the shrimp with a little salt and pepper. Lightly coat them in flour. Just lightly.
Wow.
All right?
Just lightly, okay.
Just lightly, like this. All right. Then we're going to get right them.
Mm-hmm. Oh, wow.
Oh, you got to barely touch the flour, like
right.
that. We're going to fry them in a pan with rendered bacon fat.
Oh,
clearly, this is not a dish you're going to eat before the marathon, unless you're running south.
Oh, my gosh.
But,
is that delicious, Debbie?
Oh my gosh.
So, and we go like that, right?
Fabio, holy, my goodness.
Holy, careful with the holy. It's a Hallmark channel.
No, that's
you know,
okay.
We got it.
Holy
all
mackerel.
Right, all right, holy where? Mackerel.
Holy mackerel.
All right.
I said holy, my goodness.
We're going to fry.
Yeah, yeah, it's a lot.
Delicious.
Little yes. bacon fat and shrimps. Once these are fried, right here we have some sauteed mushroom.
Mm-hmm.
Rendered bacon, which is also, you know, why we got the
right.
we got
could
that.
Could you use pancetta?
Yes, you can use pancetta, but would you argue with somebody from South Carolina
no,
about
I
pancetta?
No, I do not argue with
pancetta. Is a good substitution if you don't have bacon.
Okay.
But you know, bacon is. I think it's kind of easy to find in America.
Oh yeah, it's very.
Very right.
Yeah. Okay.
We have green onion, mm-hmm. and then we have two extra things. We have chipotle paste for the little kick, and we have lime juice. Yeah. So here's what we're gonna do now. We're gonna flip our shrimp.
Yeah. It should probably be the heat should have been a little hotter, right? And then because
yeah, but last yep. time I was here,
yeah, you
I
were
almost
scared.
Set the
so he
fire.
Put it down to nothing.
So I put it down to nothing now.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, doing mistake, it's okay. Doing the same mistake
twice
it's annoying.
Yeah. Yeah, last day nearly burned down
right.
the house.
No, but you know, it's bacon fat. So also with the medium heat, it's gonna sear
right.
nicely.
Okay.
Then we're gonna add the bacon on it, inside.
That looks so delicious.
We're going to add sauté mushroom.
What did you sauté the mushrooms in?
Just a tad of olive oil.
Oh, that's it.
Do you have friends in South Carolina? Is that how this came about?
I have a friend in South Carolina. Actually, one of my greatest co-workers is from down there. And that's the only reason he could have yelled at me, because I normally do the yelling. Yeah. But he said, no, that's a recipe traditional with my family. We'll teach you how to do it. And I said, can I put it in the cookbook? Because it was so good.
Yeah.
And he said, absolutely not. And I still did it because I did add my own twist, which is a tad of a lime juice to bring a touch of acidity to the actual dish.
It brightens it up.
Brightens it up.
Yeah.
Then we have
what is this called? My friend's dish with a touch of lime juice, so it's not copyright infringement.
Yeah, exactly.
It is exactly what it is. So once you have these, all you gotta do is to let it reduce on the fire, and then look at this, Christina. We have beautiful grits right here.
Oh,
right.
Grits
so
is nothing else than you know. To begin with, is kind of cornmeal prepped in a certain way.
Grits
with
is nothing more than polenta.
Mm-hmm. It's well, kind cornmeal. Of it. We had a little debate earlier,
it's
but
polenta.
It's kind of an American version of polenta with milk and broth.
What kind of broth? Vegetable, chicken, beef?
I'll go with the chicken broth.
Okay.
If you're vegan, you shouldn't be eating this dish, so why bother? No, it's not nice.
No.
You can avoid the pancetta and the shrimp and the milk, and why bother?
I mean, it is what it is.
Don't make the
I'm
recipe.
Offended by that. I'm a vegetarian who eats shrimp and bacon, but just not in my broth. I need a vegetarian broth.
But if you think about it, pigs
ate
acorn. Acorn is vegan, so kind of pig is vegan. I mean, it's a train of thought.
What?
Clever.
Christina,
clever.
It's a train.
So okay.
Pigs eat acorn. Acorn is is vegan. It's like whatever. It's not meat.
Right.
So kind of pig is processed acorn.
Are you supposed to eat the shell like Debbie just did?
It was an accident. It was
what happened,
tail of the tail of the shrimp.
So seagulls.
Is that real? Seagulls do?
Yeah, they do.
So you're saying humans do whatever seagulls can do.
So here's what we do, what we're doing now. We're adding some cheddar cheese, and we're adding some grana padano to the grits.
That's cheese.
Cheese, yes.
Are you allowed to say grana padano on Hallmark Channel?
Grana
padano, that's Italian twist to the South Carolina dish. Then we're going to add a couple of pieces of butter, and what? Look at that. Diced chorizo.
Oh, wow.
That's what that is. Christina, you are about to take a trip to the heaven of culinary in South Carolina.
To the where?
Heaven of culinary.
Heaven of culinary.
All right, you ready?
South Cackalacky, Christina.
If grits were that good, I would have moved south.
Uh-huh. All right, hold on. Hold on.
By the way, how long does it take to make grits? Is that like one of the things that's cooked for a long time?
Depend. You know, some people like it a little bit more gritty. Some people like it a little creamier. I think that a good 25 minutes for a good grit. Okay.
It's not too much. Is that why called grits? Because it's gritty?
Mm-hmm. Well, yes, no.
Well, yes and no.
No, you know what I need with this? I need a beautiful, I have to
taste
this.
And then, the best part today, we got a little surprise. You guys are having some wine.
Ooh, what kind of wine?
We're having a Cabernet Sauvignon from California. And we have a Chardonnay from California. And check this out, Mark.
Yes, sir.
You know what's happening? You're drinking my own wine. Look at that.
No way.
Yeah. Oh. You know, I have been in business of drinking wine since I was 5. Italian rules. Who's counting? It's Italian. And I've been in business of selling wine through my restaurant, so I decided to create our own collection. And today, that's what you guys are drinking, Cabernet Sauvignon.
Oh, my goodness.
What's the 78 and 90? What does that mean?
That's the year I was born.
Me too.
78 face. Oh. There is a good story. You can go to the website and check out the story, FabioViviani.com. It's a cute story. Yes, sir.
I'm not saying that everybody else here doesn't love your food. They clearly do. But I think I really love your food.
He wins. Ben,